Hey, it's Scott Fox from expertwebsitereviews.com and clickmillionaires.com. I'm here with an expert website review of cheapseoservices.org. This is the website of my new friend Linus from Lithuania. Thanks, Linus, for dropping by expertwebsitereviews.com. Let's see what we can do to help you improve your conversions. Linus sent me an email and he said he wanted to focus on improving his product appeal, increasing conversions, and of course, making some more money. So I'm going to help him out here and give him my objective opinion based on my years of experience and success in the online world. Cheap SEO services. Well, you've got a good domain there, Linus. I have to ask you though why you don't have the .com. Of course, the keywords you have in that domain are all highly desirable, and I'm guessing .com isn't available, but we'll start right there with a .org is good, but a .com is better. So if you can get that, of course, I'd grab that. Now, my first impression of the site is it's professional looking. It's very together. It looks like a real business. I like it. But I can see why you're having some trouble converting customers. So let's walk through the site a bit from, say, let's say from top to bottom, and we'll get to some of the other pages and the questions that you asked as well, all as part of the expert website review you paid for from expertwebsitereviews.com. So, providing the best solutions for optimizing your business. Okay, well, that's a reasonable goal. I wonder if that couldn't be a little more keyword heavy. Solutions are something that consultants and service providers love to talk about, but I've never heard a customer say they were looking for solutions. That's kind of a buzzword, and I wonder if you couldn't clean that up a little. But more strategically speaking, we can talk about little pieces here, but I think the fundamental question I have for you, Linus, is, well, first of all, who's your market? Are you looking at the UK or the US? Because I can tell you right away, you've got a UK phone number here, 44, and that's fine if you're looking at European customers, but US customers will have no idea what to do with that. So if you're really playing with the phone approach, you've got a Skype link up here and then this phone number here, I would figure out a way to get a US phone number or remove that entirely. Because to me, as an American, and believe me, I know the UK, I've lived and worked there, okay? It doesn't scare me away, but I would immediately think, well, isn't there somebody closer that I could call? And I think you'd be better just removing that, and then you might get some business from the States, certainly from Americans who haven't traveled abroad as much as I have. Now, I think the larger picture I have a question with, or maybe even trouble with, is you're asking me about improving your product appeal. And here's the issue that I identified pretty quickly. You've got these cute little icons that identifies each of your services. I think there's a lot of them here. It's a little bit overwhelming, honestly, so you might want to cut, I don't know, at least maybe two of these so there was only 3 by 2 instead of 4 by 2. But even more than that, when I go to click on these things, I'm not sure what I'm getting. All I get is this one little page with not a lot of sell, actually. So for 300 bucks, honestly, I want a little more than this. And on the home page, you have even less than that. Because what I naturally do is if this is interesting and there's only this much copy with this little ellipsis, the dot, dot, dot that you have right here, I naturally look at the order now. So first of all, I'd make the order now buttons a different color. They really blend right in there. Put the graphics to work. I mean, even if they were just blue or maybe green matching your header, I think they'd be a lot more eye-catching and suggest to people, oh, I can order now. But fundamentally, the problem is when you click this order now, you've got this clever little bit. I guess this is some Ajax or JavaScript or something. You want me to do what? You want me to fill out my name, email, website, and comments? This is all I get to do? And then order, and I order here, and then I did this earlier, and then it goes to PayPal. You need to sell this a lot more, my friend. You've got the opportunity to do this. See there, it popped over to PayPal. That's not a bad way to do things. I don't mind PayPal. I use it myself for clickmillionaires.com. And you, Linus, you paid through PayPal for this expert website review that you're getting. But you've got these pages set up already. I think you could save, get rid of these little blurbs or something, and give somebody some more meat. If you're asking for $200, $300, $500 at a time, I think that this page that you click to, you've really got to say something, or at least put some line breaks between these paragraphs, these sentences, so that the paragraphs look like something. You're asking for a lot of money for very little, and I think that would help you a lot in terms of your product appeal. That's something that you asked me about. And how about some pictures, some screenshots, something more friendly? These icons and all this, it looks professional, but it's also rather cold. And that's the other thing I would suggest is really personalizing this a little bit. Maybe, Linus, you don't want your personal face up there, but this feels very much like an optimized site provided by an anonymous company, and It looks reasonably trustworthy, but it also doesn't differentiate itself. And I think you have an opportunity to do that. How you want to do that, I'm not sure. I don't know you well enough. But if you wanted to come join clickmillionaires.com, we could talk about it in the forum and maybe help you work out a suggestion of how to personalize this. But one of the places is, of course, on the About Us page. I looked at this earlier. We're a privately held company located in Lithuania and Germany. That sounds impressive and it may sound good to you, but again, if you're looking at Americans, that's almost scary. Right? I mean, what's Lithuania? Most Americans probably don't know. They've heard of Germany, but it's a long way away. And you have an office building here, and then you have your map. I mean, this is all cool, but honestly, it's not really very helpful. I'd rather see a picture of you, Linus, and maybe some of your friends, and this is our team, and this is where we work, and something credibility building. Or here's a photo of our founder and some links to some articles he's written or his credibility or something. I mean, you got to sell this a little bit. And this is very much about features rather than benefits. So I would suggest looking at the whole site again, to think in terms of benefits. What does the user get out of this? Now, this is nice. You have this comparison page where you compare and contrast the different packages you have, and this gives some more explanation. I don't know. You might even want to put this on the homepage. It goes on and on here. It's a lot of material, but I think you need to sort of pick your, I don't know, three, four, five, maybe six top products and give us more information right from the start and certainly on their individual pages so that people can appreciate the services that you're offering and frankly asking them to pay for. Now let's move on. I'll assume you got that point. You got the chess pieces. That's kind of a nice allusion to strategy. Success story is always a nice idea. You're giving a lot of space to this guy. This looks like an ad almost for ShareNator.com. Is that really the best use of this space? You know what I'd like to see here? Is either your contact info. In fact, you suggested also in your email to me maybe adding a colorful thumb on the homepage that offers people to get a website quote, like a services quote, maybe, or analyze your website. Same idea, something colorful in here that allows the audience to interact. But what I'd like most is an email sign up. If you've gone to the trouble of attracting someone here, I think you should be getting their attention. And this is such valuable real estate that you could use better without rearranging your whole website. Cheaply and cost effectively, you could put your email collector in here. Now, you had it in here somewhere. Where was it? I saw an email collector. Well, you see, now I can't even find it again, so I guess that proves my point. But there should be right here. Interested in cheap SEO services? Sign up for our free email newsletter. You'll get a coupon for 10% off our services right away. Or something like that, a free ebook or an article or a video of you explaining things, whatever it is, but something that entices them into further interaction so that you can hear from them again. If they've come to this site and they've already voted that they're kind of interested, that's a hot prospect. And you don't want their only choices to be, here, give me a $149 or leave. In between is get an email address and then you can keep in touch. Now these other pages, let's see, moving down the page. Okay, so you've got a Facebook link here. Now that seems fine to me, but honestly, if you only've got one like, my friend, I'm not sure that's doing you any favors. You might want to move that down the page or get more active on Facebook. If I see something that only has one like, it makes me question your credibility. And if you're smart about this stuff, I would go get some more likes. And or just move this down to the bottom of the page. I'm a fan of Facebook too. I think it's a good tool, but with only one like, it questions your credibility a little bit. Additional services. Now, this is other links to these same stuff. So I don't know if this is the best use of your site, but the real estate you have available here. But these are also SEO optimized, I'm sure. So this is helping people find these services, and I can kind of understand that. But I guess basically I would give more information on each of these so that when I click on one, as I'm doing here on directory submission service, you get something more than this little form. This is you're trying a little too hard to automate that. Or frankly, at least if you're going to do this form, make the fields bigger. Like what's my website description is only supposed to be, what does this hold about 12 words, And my comments, I'm asking you for something personal here. You can I know you can drag these, but most people aren't even going to realize that, or they're not going to go to the trouble. So I would make these forms bigger, like I just did there, and it allow people to give you the feedback that they want to share. They're asking for your opinion, so I would entice them into further use. When you filled out your request for this service at expertwebsitereviews.com, you actually used a form that I use from WooFoo Forums, and that was actually very easy and affordable, and I recommend WooFoo.com if you're interested in that. But it looks like you have enough programming skills to have pulled this off yourself, so just make those fields bigger, my friend. I think that would entice people to interact with you a little more. Then you also mentioned that you were interested in selling ongoing subscriptions. Now that makes sense to me. I think that ongoing subscriptions is a nice way to make money. SEO is a constantly evolving field, but I don't really see that here. If subscriptions are really what you're after, I would put that on the homepage. Here's a subscription, like sell that. If that's really what you want to sell, and I understand why recurring revenues are great, then I would make a point of it here on the homepage. So I hope that's helpful to you. I like the site. I like what you're doing. It all makes sense, but I think you're right, and I'm glad you came to me so that hopefully this objective third-party view from me will help you sort of reconfigure it a little bit. You've got the right pieces. I'd cut down, simplify a little. Again, if you're going to be talking to US audiences, I would put a US phone number up or take away the phone number. And if you're not talking to US audiences, then I would stop quoting things in dollars and start quoting them in pounds or euros or yen or whatever it is you're targeting. Let's see, what else can we do here before we run out of time for you? This all looks pretty good, but I think I really my fundamental point for you is making these product pages more interesting. And I think you need to explain a little more what's in it. On this page, I guess you've got a bunch here below the form. But I would bring that up to the top. I would make this a little more visually interesting, maybe some stock photos, or ideally, like I said, photos of you, your team, your friends, maybe satisfied customers. And I think that that would really help you improve your conversions and increase your product appeal. Now here you've got feedback. Feedbacks is not a word in English, it's feedback, so I'd get rid of this S. And if this is actual, these are actual testimonials from people, then I would play this up a little bit. Maybe put these in quotation marks so that they look like things people said. See if you can get your friends here, DL Jackson and Farrar and T Montana, to Tony Montana, to put up maybe some thumbnails of their pictures or something so that these look like real people. Even better than relegating your feedback to this one page is to mix it in on the homepage. And again, that suggests a little bit of redesign of your landing page so that you give more product information, more benefits, and actually put some of these testimonials on the homepage, ideally with pictures of the people that said them. So I hope that's helpful to you, Linus. I appreciate hearing from you. You're my first customer all the way from Lithuania. So I hope that's helpful to you, and I appreciate you stopping by expertwebsitereviews.com to order this. And we'll be sending this over to you as a customized website review just as soon as I finish talking. So thank you for visiting, and thanks to anybody else who visited this. If you're interested in cheap SEO services, try Linus's cheapseoservices.org. Thanks for watching.